says. Okay.
At this time, can sergeants please start the recordings? Okay, Sergeant Hope, take it away.
Good morning and welcome to the Committee on Finance. At this time, would all panelists please turn on their videos? I repeat, all panelists, please turn on your videos. Thank you. To minimize disruption, please place all electronic devices to vibrate or silent. I repeat, please place all electronic devices to vibrate or silent. Chair Drum, we're ready to begin.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much, and good morning, and welcome to today's Finance Committee meeting. I am Councilmember Daniel Drum, and I am the chair of the committee. We have been joined by the following council members: Councilmembers Cornegie, Cumbo, Koslowitz, Rosenthal, Van Bremer, Grodenchik, Adams, Ayala, Moya, Powers, Lewis, Matteo, Joni, Amphrey Samuel, Chin, Brannon, Perkins, and Cohen. Today, the committee will be voting on seven items, which includes four bills, two land use items, and a transparency resolution. Let's start with the four pieces of legislation. Proposed intro number 2039A, sponsored by myself at the request of the mayor, would extend the deadline for the filing of an application or a renewal application due in calendar year 2020 from March 16th, 2020 to July 15th, 2020 for certain real property tax exemption or tax abatement programs. The programs include the senior citizen homeowners exemption, the disabled homeowners exemption, the veterans exemption, and the alternative veterans exemption, the school tax relief exemption, the disabled crime victim Good Samaritan exemption, the clergy exemption, and the cooperative and condominium property tax abatement. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, New York City was forced to shut down the normal order of business to help stop the spread of the coronavirus, which included gatherings of people at workshops, seminars, and in-person visits to offices to normally assist people navigating technical matters like filling out real property tax application and renewal documents. According to the Department of Finance, approximately 2,650 eligible initial and renewal applications were received after the existing deadline of March 16, 2020, but prior to July 15, 2020. By extending the deadline for filing the property tax exemption and tax abatement programs to July 15th, this bill will make sure that these property owners can receive their tax benefits now instead of having to wait until next year to apply again. Next is proposed intro number 1225A. This bill, which I've also sponsored, would require the Department of Finance to make best efforts to collect the name, telephone number, and email address of all owners of real property, and once such information is received, to ensure that it is maintained in a computer database used by the department for purposes of administering the real property tax. Currently, the Department of Finance does not have a systematic approach to collecting and maintaining telephone and email contact information for property owners in order to communicate with them regarding their properties and property taxes. Instead, it primarily relies on physical mailings to contact owners. This bill will encourage the agency to collect the data necessary to use alternative, more effective methods of communication and outreach to disseminate information to property owners in a faster, more efficient way. I'd like to thank the Council Finance Division staff who worked on these two bills: Senior Counsel Rebecca Chasen, Assistant Director Emra Edev, Assistant Counsel Stephanie Ruiz, and Finance Analyst Luke Zangerli. Excuse me if I messed up the pronunciation of that last name. Next is proposed intro 1702A. This bill, sponsored by Councilmember Koslowitz, would require the Department of Finance to include a notice on property tax bills that use prior year's tax rate that the taxes due are subject to adjustment upon the adoption of the tax rate for the new fiscal year. And the last of the bills is proposed intro number 1705A. This bill, sponsored by Councilmember Mattio, would require the Department of Finance to establish and maintain a system to contact property owners by email and provide access electronically to a receipt for an information on each payment made for charges on their statement of account. I will now give Council Members Koslowitz and Mattio an opportunity to speak about their legislation. Council Member Koslowitz.
This is just to notify people. Many people get the bill in June and they get surprised when they get another bill. And this will, the bill that comes in June will tell them what this bill is all about, and there'll be another bill coming, so they won't be surprised when they get the bill. I've gotten many calls in the office claiming that I paid it, and why am I getting another bill? So this will alleviate that problem.
Thank you, Councilmember Koslowitz. Minority Leader Mattio.
Thank you, Chair Drum. Intro 1705 will create an electronic receipt system for payments on property taxes. Since the city instituted the electronic payment system, there has been no proof of payment issued by the city for online payers of property taxes. You can get a receipt if you pay in person at one of the New York City Department of Finance's centers, but not online. Payers have to wait for the next quarterly statement to know with certainty that DOF has properly attributed their payment to their account. This legislation will change that and allow individuals to sign up for payment receipts related to their property or at the point of payment so that they have a definitive statement from the city that their tax bill has been paid. This is just basic fairness and makes the online payment system the city has had for some time even more convenient. This legislation will not come into effect until next fiscal year because I'm sensitive to adding the cost of our agencies during this challenging time, even if it's at a minimal cost, and I wanted to ensure that this new feature did not make belt tightening any harder than it needed to be. I thank the administration for negotiating this legislation in good faith and appreciate the work that was done to bring the bill to passage, especially Kenny Grace. I want to thank Jason Goldman, our finance committee, counsel Rebecca Chasen, Emery Edviv, Stephanie Ruiz, and my chief of staff, David Carr. I also want to thank the speaker and Chair Drum for their support. I urge my colleagues to vote yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minority Leader Mattio. We have also been joined by Council Member Yeager. Next, we have two resolutions related to the property tax exemptions. The two resolutions relate to a project called Albany-Kingston in Councilmember Carnegie's district. The resolutions would approve the termination of two prior Article 5 tax exemptions granted by the council in 2007 and consent to do a voluntary dissolution of the current Article 5 owners. Councilmember Carnegie is supportive of these actions. The last item is the transparency resolution. The transparency resolution sets forth the new designation and changes in the designation of certain organizations receiving local aging, anti-poverty, and youth discretionary funding and funding pursuant to certain initiatives in the budget. As with all transparency resolutions, council members will have to sign a disclosure form indicating whether or not a conflict exists with any of the groups on the attached list. If any council member has a potential conflict of interest with any of the organizations listed, he or she has the opportunity to disclose the conflict at the time of their vote. As a reminder, please disclose any conflicts you may have with proposed subcontractors used by organizations sponsored by discretionary funding. These disclosures must be made before the subcontractor can approve. Disclosure forms must be completed and submitted prior to the vote on the transparency resolution and may be emailed to Charles Davis. We have also been joined by Council Members Koo and Cohen. And are there any questions on any of the legislation? Okay, I will now ask Billy Martin, committee clerk, to call the roll.
Good morning. William Martin, committee clerk, roll call vote, committee on finance. All items are coupled. Chair Drum.
I vote aye.
Cornegie.
Aye.
Cumbo.
I vote aye.
Kozlowicz.
Aye.
Rosenthal. Van Bramer.
Aye.
Grudenchik.
Aye.
Adams.
I vote aye. Posted
wrong, but on both sides. And Priest Samuel.
I'd like to disclose on the record that today we'll be voting on a transparency resolution, and my brother is a teacher with the Department of Education in the event there is a conflict. I vote aye.
Thank you. Rosenthal.
I'm sorry, did you call my name again, Billy?
Yes, Councilmember Rosenthal.
I voted aye. Thank you.
Ayala. Councilmember Ayala.
Aye.
Thank you. Jonai.
Vote aye.
Moya.
I vote aye.
Powers.
I vote aye. Thank you.
Lewis.
I would like to vote on this resolution that my sisters are adding.
In here.
Councilmember, my apologies. I lost your audio for a moment.
I'll do that. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
All right. I just wanted to say I disclose on the record that my sister works as an adjunct professor at CUNY, which may pose as a conflict, and I wanted to vote aye on all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Gibson.
Good morning. I vote aye.
Thank you. Mario.
Aye.
One moment. Okay, by a vote of 16 in the affirmative, 0 in the negative, and no abstentions, all items have been adopted by the committee. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And with that, I will adjourn this meeting at approximately